Beautiful.
Beautiful Liberace. Thank you. Good evening,
my friends and fans.
Good evening. It's Saturday night, and this is Sandy Beach's Saturday Night Special. So happy you joined me tonight. I gotta look here, see if anybody said anything. See if anybody said hi to me. Oh, look. Oh, wow. Hey, Meg, you're back. So glad to see you. Cam, Kathleen, Warner, Braden. Hey, everybody. So glad to see you. Tonight, my friends and fans, I'm so excited. Hello, Sharna. I'm so excited about tonight's theme. I mean, I'm excited and, I'm really excited about it. I think you're going to get excited about it, too. But before I get started, I wanted to put on this terrible, sad song. This is a Moonlight Sonata. Try it. My name is Sandy Beaches. Listen, if you're just joining me for the first time, it's Saturday night. Every Saturday night is Sandy night. Sandy Beaches Saturday night special. My name is Sandy Beaches. And I've been here since March. I've been here at CC's apartment. My best friend lives in St. Louis, Mo. And I'm a guitar player on a cruise ship band. And everybody in my cruise ship got furloughed back in March of 2020. And I called CC and I said, hey, CC, can I come out to St. Louis and stay with you for a couple weeks while I'm on furlough? Well, 2 weeks stretched out. As many of y'all know, as we are, kind of trying to climb ourselves out of a global pandemic. Who knew? Who knew that was going to happen? It's not the first time. It's not the first time it's happened. I am fond of reminding y'all that Liberace, who provides my walking music every week, died from pneumonia brought on by AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, which was a global pandemic. It is. It is a global pandemic. AIDS didn't go away, people. People learn to live with it. We learn how to treat it. But that's what happened, you know. Get a new disease out there. So anyway, I digress. I'm here in St. Louis at CC's, and we've been having a really good time, you know. It's been a good time. You'd think maybe we'd be struggling a little bit more, but the generosity of CC's friends and fans and my friends and fans have been keeping us afloat, and we've really had a wonderful time. And every week I bring you a new show, and I've been having so much fun. Oh no, Joyce tells us Ebola's back in action, so there's something to monitor. Anyway, I don't even remember what I was saying now, but I poured myself a couple of drinks tonight, people. This is a double rye. This is High West double rye whiskey. I poured myself 3 fingers, as is my usual. Cheers in my Sandy Beaches commemorative whiskey glass. If you don't have your glasses yet, get in touch. 1 for $10 or 4 for $30. CC will ship them anywhere in the U.S. for an extra $10. Cheers, everybody. Cheers. I'll support myself a cold refreshing drink. Hey, you know what, Joyce? It's not you. You know, it's not your fault. And it's a delicious incarnation from Four Hands, my favorite brewery here in St. Louis. Woohoo, Bo! Bo's here watching. He made my cool logo. Alright, well, that was sad. That was a sad song. Well, listen, a lot's going on here tonight. Cheers. I've been looking forward to this show for a while because I knew this day was coming, and I knew that today, February 20th, 2021, was a special day for my friend Cece. And this is a day that she has commemorated every single year for 27 years. This is the 27th anniversary of Cece's... That's funny, Holly. I got distracted. Of CC's own dad's death. CC's dad died when she was 18 years old in 1994. By my count, that's 27 years. 27 years ago. Tonight! And I knew that this fell on a Saturday, and so I've been looking forward to this theme for quite some time, because I know that Cece likes to, she likes to do something special on this date, on February 20th, every year. She likes to remember her dad, and remember the good times they had, and also commemorate that important, special occasion of his death, which it was a pivotal time in my best friend's life. You know, so she likes to actually commemorate that very day. And what she likes to do is kind of like come up with a theme, if you can believe it. Cece likes themes as much as I do. And so usually she likes to try to, on that day to commemorate her dad's death, sort of encapsulate the year that has gone before in some way. And you know what? She thought that this was perfect. She thought, oh, well, if there's one way to commemorate this last year, it's you, Sandy. So please, by all means, take over my celebration this year. Well, I'm honored to do it. And I encountered 12. I've got 12 songs on my list. This is going to be a long show. We're really going through it tonight, people. 12 songs all about death and loss. Now, look, I like to have a good time and joke around and play and have fun. So this isn't going to be all doom and gloom. Hi, Sarah Kate. But it is mostly doom and gloom. I'm going to tell you that. We're not really messing around. These songs are sad. And one thing that's interesting is all of these songs, almost every single one of these songs, was an international worldwide hit. Now, I wonder if the reason why that is because these songs were written about death and loss. And that really touched, it really struck a chord with people, you know? And so for that reason, these songs became great hits. I also noticed, and Cece mentioned this too, we've been talking about this, it seems like in these months, like February and November, kind of these months that are right on the edge before the season changes, a lot of death happens. And I've been noticing, you know, amongst friends and fans all over the world, a lot of death. Plus, we got this global pandemic. That's for real, people. There's people are losing family members and friends. A lot of death, a lot of loss going on, you know? And, yeah, I thought, Kathleen, this one's right up your alley, ain't it? So anyway, we're all processing a lot of death and a lot of loss, you know, in our lives. That's just how it goes. Sandy, did I spell Celia's dad's name correctly? No, it was Quentin with a T-O-N. Quentin, but you know what? Nobody called him that. Every single person I ever knew called him Shaq. Even Cece's old mom. So if you can believe that. Shaq. Quentin Shaq Shacklett, born in 1930, died in 1994. And so this show is dedicated to him, but this show is also dedicated to you and to helping you, you know, get in touch with your own feelings about death and loss. And maybe you got somebody who's gone on before that you would like to grieve, or maybe, you know, maybe these songs, I don't know. I don't know how you want to do this with me, but we're going to do it. I gotta tell you, the second set gets deep, man. I mean, even the first one. Every part of this. They're all these songs are about death and loss. So, that's what we're doing tonight. I think we'll probably have a pretty good time. I, for one, think it's fun to sing songs. Started. I can't decide what to have. I think I'll go with this Three Fingers. Cheers, y'all. Cheers. Love you a lot. Wes, that's it. That's the joke I wish I had in my back pocket. You just gave it to me. Wes says we're going to put the fun back in funeral tonight. That's right. This first song I'm going to play, I played this song for you before, actually. This song is from a 1972 record called Baby, I'ma Want You. It's one of my favorite bands, Bread. And this song went to number 5 in the U.S. and the U.K. Written about David Gates' dad. His dad died in 1963 before that band ever got famous. And he wrote this song about his dad. And it goes a little further. The story goes a little further than that. They said David Gates gave his mother an orchid when he was a young boy. And his mother loved it so much that his dad said to him, you know what? She loves that orchid so much, she'd give you anything she owned. And that came back to him later on when his dad died. And he wrote this song, Everything I Own. I sang this to you before on the 4th show I ever did for you, Desire and Commitment. That was April 11th, 2020. You sheltered me from harm, kept me warm, kept me warm. You gave my life to me, set me free, set me free. The finest years I ever lived were all the years I had with you. And I would give everything I own, give up my life, my heart, my home. I would give everything I own just to have you back again. You taught me how to love, what it's all, what it's all. Never said too much, but still you showed the way, and I knew from watching you. You know the feeling? You know the feeling. Flower power, huh? I like that. I like that. Thanks, Brad. What a beautiful tune. Well, this next song is a storied... It's an old, old song. It's one of the oldest songs I ever played for you. I think. Cheers. This song about... My dying. This song about me dying. Or you dying. Or it's about a personal prayer about death. Whoopsie. So, that's an old blues song, an old gospel blues number. I'm playing a new guitar tonight. I never played this for you. This is one of Cece's guitar. Actually, it's kind of a guest. It's kind of a guest in Cece's house. It's called Stella. Stella's an old department store guitar. They used to sell these at Montgomery Ward's and stuff like that. Cece picked it up for $100. She likes to buy little guitars and then resell them sometimes to kids. She finds a little guitar in good shape. She likes to buy them up, keep them around the house, play them, putting strings on them. So Cece got a big idea tonight. We need to tune a guitar to open tuning for this song. So she said, well, why don't you use that little Stella guitar? And then you don't have to tune all of your other ones up. She thought it might sound cool with this slide. I got slide to that. And this song is an old blues, an old gospel blues song. One of the first recordings is by Blind Willie. One of the first recordings that we know about anyways is Blind Willie Johnson, somewhere in the 1920s, recorded this song. Probably been around a lot longer than that. This was also, Bob Dylan brought this song out into kind of the popular music scene on his first album in 1962, called Bob Dylan. It was on Bob Dylan's first album, 1962. And then a lot of you might recognize some of the themes of this song from a song from Led Zeppelin's record called Physical Graffiti. Came out in 1975. Their sixth album. Thank you. We love you too. We love you too. All right, well, that was very exciting. Very exciting. I've been wanting to play this song for a long time. Well, let's get this other guitar. This is Mitzi. That's a CC's 12 string. You're familiar with this one? Well, y'all probably know this song because this is a huge, huge hit. 1970 from a record called Sweet Baby James. James Taylor wrote this song as a reaction to a childhood friend's suicide. His friend Suzanne killed herself at some point, and they wrote this song. Also, he was mourning the loss of a band that he really believed in, that he loved. And, you know, he's working out some of his feelings. That's what we do, right? With music. a lot of times. Well, this song was number 2 in Canada and number 3 in the United States. He actually wrote this song in rehab. He had some things going on at that time. He was in rehab and he wrote this song. And when he got out, he recorded this song in the studio. And I don't know if y'all know this. The recording's so beautiful, totally iconic. James Taylor recording. And Carole King played the piano on that recording. So when you go out there later on tonight and you're YouTube and all the songs I played and you want to hear the original versions, listen to that. Carole King's playing piano on that. Hold on, let me tune that guitar. Lots of strings, you know. If they don't all sound good. And I tell you, one doesn't sound good, none of them do. You know what I'm saying? Mitzi's getting workout tonight. I got several Mitzi tunes. So if you know this song, I hope you're singing along at home. I always hope that, but
walked out this morning and I rolled down this
I mean, I get it. That was his childhood friend, you know? You always think you'll see them again, right? Cheers, y'all. I love you, too. I love you, too. Braden and all y'all. Those hearts, y'all are freaking out. I know. I knew it was going to be emotional tonight. I'm feeling emotional. It's beautiful. These are beautiful songs about loss and death. And you know, what's more real than that? You know, what's more like, what cuts closer to the bone than death? Nothing. That's what. Maybe brand new life, but even then you get distracted as soon as you come alive. You know what I'm saying? Death's like the one thing. It's all by itself. Well, this next song is another international hit. Now, this song, it's kind of special to me, especially because, you know, I'm a cruise ship guitar player, so I spend a lot of time on a cruise ship, and this song comes from a movie about a cruise ship, Doomed Cruise Ship. Yeah, you know the one, James Cameron's 1998 epic. You know the one. That's before Avatar. There was Titanic. Okay. Now look, here's the story I heard about this song. I like this story. James Cameron didn't want a song. He didn't want there to be a song. But he had the composers that were making the music for the movie, and they were like, "Oh, we gotta write this song." And they got Celine Dion to sing it. And James Cameron was like, "Well, okay, whatever, I guess so." Because they said, "No song, no Celine." And everybody knew that Celine Dion would make this song a huge worldwide hit. Well, she did. It's become one of her signature songs. Yeah, Braden, I'm actually so glad you're watching, because I thought of you today when I was practicing this song. Because I know you love Celine Dion. Oh, Amber, thank you for saying that. I would encourage any of y'all, if you want to reach out and tell folks who, somebody in your life you grieve tonight, I think that'd be fine. So here it is. This is a song, and you know, like I've told you all this many times, I can't sing it like Celine Dion can sing it, you know, but I can sing this song. I can interpret it. I'm an interpreter. That's what I do. So maybe this'll shed some light on this song for you in a way that you never heard it before. I don't know. Oh, I wanted to say a couple more facts about this. This song was written by James Horner and Will Jennings for the movie Titanic. This topped the charts in over 20 countries. Okay? 20 countries. This song won an Oscar. It swept the Grammys that year. It won a Golden Globe. This song will go on forever, okay? I'm serious. So here you go. Here's my version. But you know what? My heart will go on. It's a thing about some of these songs, like they're sort of like encouraging those that go ahead. You know? Is your heart going on and on for my kitty cats right there? What are they doing? I don't know what she found, but... Oh, I'm so glad you like that, Brayden. I can't believe you saw that tonight, because I was seriously thinking about you today. Well, listen, this next song... I've been waiting to get this artist in this set for a while. And this is kind of out of left field. I think some of you might be a little surprised by this, but some of you who know me well, you're not gonna be too surprised because you know I think his name was Jack in that movie Matthew. It wasn't Leo, okay? Leo lived on to make Wolves of Wall Street and The Revenant, which by the way was another movie where he almost died, but then he didn't. Looked like he was going to freeze to death and get eaten by a bear and everything else, but he didn't. The Revenant means somebody who comes back from the dead, which is not what happened in that movie, but it kind of seemed like it, which is probably why they gave it that name. Anyway, I digress. It's not what this next song's about. This next song is from... This next song is from a record that was very popular. Wow, I cannot believe how y'all have some passionate feelings about Titanic. I think it was a fictional movie about a real story. I'm not sure if that... But I will tell you this week, just because whatever, probably because the internet heard me singing that song and they were showing me stuff on the internet about Titanic. I saw the alternate ending... where the people see her throw that jewel off into the ocean is really great. It was totally great. All right. Well, this song anyway. We're moving on. We're now to the next song. Yeah, I know it's so funny, right? This next song is from a record called Little Earthquakes. It came out in 1992. By a great pianist and singer and writer named Tori Amos. Now, Tori Amos is a worldwide superstar, kind of a cult favorite. People have been following her for many, many years, and this was her debut album. It made a huge splash. It had a lot of really meaningful songs. And when I told Cece I wanted to dedicate a song to her dead dad day, I said, is there any song that comes to mind for you? And she said, well, I remember this song that was out when I was in high school and when my dad died. She was a senior in high school when her dad died, and she was listening to this record, Little Earthquakes by Tori Amos, and it had this one song that Tori wrote about her dad. And Cece's dad died like today, right? February 20th, right in the middle of winter. And this song is about winter, and it's about her relationship with her father. So it's kind of a natural fit. So this is a Tori Amos song. Like I said, I've been looking for a way to get Tori Amos in this set for a long time. Last week we had Gals and Pals was our theme, and it was all like women rockers, and I was kind of thinking maybe Tori Amos would get in that set, but didn't quite. So let's see how this goes. Once again, I don't think this is like sounds like Tori Amos or anything, but it's a song, so I'm going to interpret that song. Spit deeper. What are y'all doing? What is this? Are y'all trying to sell a couch? Let's see. Can I see it for you? Very interesting person. The red one. No stains. The couch auction. Hilarious. What in the heck? All right, y'all. You buying my couch? Don't buy the one I sit on all the time. I don't know. All right. You work. I don't even know what's going on, but I love it. I love it. Well, good. I'm glad y'all making some fun. Making yourself having some fun. Because these songs are deep, man. Songs are deep. I don't know what's going on there. Buying and selling a couch out there. Let's see it. I need to see the couch before we start bidding. All right. Cheers, everybody. Cheers. Let's have a drink. Cheers. You can't see the couch. I love this. It's like a weirdest thread I ever saw. How much I love Ozzy Osbourne. I mean, that's like a subject comes up all the time, right? Like almost every single week. All right, like, I mean, I'm not trying to scam you, but thanks for stopping by. I hope you can get a couch. Oh, you sold the couch, mate. Good deal. Okay, I didn't know what was up. Ozzy Osbourne, y'all, my friends, is one of the greatest songwriters of the 21st century and the 20th century. I'm just going to say it right now. Yeah, did you know I love Ozzy? And this song came from a 1995 record called Osmosis. And this song is about, it's about death and dying, like all the songs are tonight. I'll see you on the other side. Thank you. see you on the other side. Yes, people. All right, well, we're taking a little break from all this talk about death. Talk about birth. It's birthday time, people. Oh, yeah, right on time. Now, I only know one birthday. I only have one birthday on my list. Warner, nope. You out there? What a sweet person. Cece told me about you, Warner, and I know you're a friend and a fan to me, Sandy Beaches, and I also know that you have sung in a group with Cece and been a part of Cece's life in other ways, too. Hey, thanks for the work that you do to educate people about consent and neurodivergency and queerness. Warner, you're an educator. Hi. Thanks a lot. That's important stuff, you know? Not everybody's just exactly the same as everybody else walking around. Everybody's special. And you're an educator and help people know that. And thank you so much for your work on Earth, Warner. I know you've been going through some hard times. Some of us have, you know, a lot of us have. A lot of struggle. So good job making it to another birthday. Look at that. Do you see that? Janani says, Warner is the literal best. Well, that is a nice thing to say. Warner, happy birthday. I think there's an echo in here. Let's sing it. Let's play the organ. Here we go. It's for Warner. Hey. If you know when somebody else has a birthday coming up or right around today, let me know. We'll sing it again. But this is for Warner. Happy birthday. Sing with me, everybody. Happy birthday. Birthday, Warner. I know some people like a twirl when I do it. Who else has a birthday? Who has a birthday song? Who has a birthday song? This song is so good. Now watch this. Time for you. And anybody who's alive knows that beats being dead. So I hope you're having a good time too. Love you. Happy birthday, everybody. Y'all, you know, singing happy birthday for a dead dad day makes a lot of sense to me. I hope that when I die, people sing dead, happy dead day to me. I hope so. It'd be great. People remember the day I died someday. That'd be good. Well, happy birthday, Warner. Hope you have a good one. Oh, good. Ready to cry more. Good, because this second set, I told you, I kind of, the lighthearted songs were at the beginning. Now it's all, we're getting down deep. But they're beautiful. They're beautiful old songs. Probably going to tune this guitar a lot, too. Get all 12 strings right. Well, this song's by a real hero of mine. Now, I don't mean to be morbid or anything, but he's going to die in our lifetime. It's pretty much for sure. Unless he's taking some kind of magical drug that will keep him alive forever. Which he actually might be doing. You know what I mean? Willie Nelson. Yeah. Willie Nelson wrote this song. He wrote this song and recorded it the first time in 1972. But then it became a hit from a movie, Honeysuckle Rose, in 1981. The song was Willie Nelson's 7th number one hit on the country charts. This song is called Angel Flying Too Close to the Ground. If you would not have fallen, then I would not have found you. Angel flying too close to the ground. And I patched up broken wing and hung around a while, trying to keep your spirits up and your fever down. I knew someday that you would fly away. For love's the greatest healer to be found. Oh, I love that bow. Your grandmother's fave. I love that. You know, there's a lady lived across the street from Cece when she was a little girl, Mina, and she loved Willie Nelson. Was her favorite. And actually, Mina was the first significant human death that Cece experienced in her young life. She had a dog or two die before that, but yeah, Willie Nelson, he means a lot to a lot of people, and he's about 80 years old or something like that, 78 or 80 years old. Bob Dylan too. You know what? You're right, Dan. We're gonna watch all our heroes die. That's the way of the world. You know, that's really true. It's really true. But there's something in there for us, you know, to keep, you know. A little message. Big message, actually, probably the message. Anyway, cheers, everybody. Having so much fun getting in touch with my feelings with you tonight. International hit. Remember I told you, so many international hits on this list because people just love songs about death. This is interesting. I didn't know this, but this is a song that's part of a trilogy. Simon Le Bon of Duran Duran wrote three songs in the memory of his friend of his who died. This song came out in 1993, a record called Duran Duran, the Wedding Album. I believe that was parenthetical. Song went to number one. The song was a number one hit by Duran Duran. And this is the second time I played a Duran Duran song for you. Not this one. I played Hungry Like the Wolf in the Cats and Dogs episode. But this is only the second time I ever played Duran Duran for y'all. Y'all remember this song? From a rainy Thursday on the avenue.
got tomorrow. Besides the news of holy war and holy need, ours is just a little sorrow.
Isn't that what it's like when you lose someone? You just gotta try to get back to that ordinary world. Oof. Well, this next song's not specifically about death. It's about loss, but to me it seems like it's about death kind of in a way, or real sad song. This song was made a hit by Sinead O'Connor. But when it was written by Prince, the one and only Prince Rogers Nelson. And, you know, when asked, you know, what do you think about Sinead O'Connor's cover? He said, I don't like it when people cover my songs, actually. I don't like that at all. So that's what Prince said about that. I will tell you this. This was on a record that Prince produced. His 1985 album with a side project band, The Family, came out 1985. It didn't become a hit until 1989 from a record called I Do Not Want What I Haven't Got. Sinead O'Connor, and she made that tearful video that was on MTV. Do you remember that? Where it was just Sinead's face, no hair. We got a situation brewing, people. Chicken bones on the floor. Kitty's got that. Okay. I got focus. Okay, so that tearful video, Sinead O'Connor's face, no hair to distract you from her face, and she's crying and it's so sad. This was a major, major worldwide hit, an international hit. You want to see my lustrous locks? Now's your chance. Oh, yes. You know, the cat's got feelings to work out too.
Nothing compares to you.
It's a late show tonight, people. Don't worry, Aaron. You're not too late because I still have like three more songs, people. This is late. This is a late show. Well, that's what happens when it's about death and loss. Is you got a lot of songs to sing about it. I think every single last one of these songs are all on Mitzi. So, George Benson, thank you so much. I think you're done tonight. I think I'm turning the amp off. It's almost like an after party. Well, we've really been through a journey tonight, people. I think this is a lot of songs about death and loss. This is another song that was on Garth Brooks's first record. His first record, and this became a signature song for Garth. I heard they sang this for Dale Earnhardt's death, and I know that anniversary just been recently. That's something. This song was written by Tony Arata. This is Garth Brooks' second number one hit. This one? Yeah, Celine and Garth Brooks. I don't know if y'all noticed, but this set was all over the place. We got Celine Dion, Ozzy Osbourne, Duran Duran, Tori Amos, Led Zeppelin. I mean, we got it all. We got it all. Cheers. Cheers, people. Love you. That's why I keep coming back every week. Because I actually do love you so much. Thank you. So simple, you know? Such a simple song. I'm glad I didn't know the way it all would end. You know, who among us would, like, if we knew what kind of pain we'd encounter in our lives, we'd say, all right, I'll do it. Sounds great. No, we probably wouldn't. You know, but the thing is, you don't get a choice. You landed, and that's a blessing. You know? And the blessing isn't just what's wonderful and good and happy and fun. It's also the pain, you know, the extremes. It's like the depth of human feeling, you know? The depth of experience we get to encounter on Earth. Sorry, I forgot what I was doing. Here's the other deal. You don't really get a choice, right? So, like, you're here. Enjoy it. You know, I mean, sometimes it hurts. Everybody hurts sometimes. Which was on the list, and I took it off because I didn't have time to sing it, but maybe another time. Hurt is part of the gift, people. You know? For real. Oh, yeah. Well, this song's so beautiful, and this is also not a song about death. This is really a song about goodbye, and it's really beautiful. And Dolly Parton wrote this song, and I love Dolly Parton, and I love Whitney Houston, who also sang this song, made a giant hit out of it. And Dolly Parton wrote this song for her collaborator and friend and producer for a long time. His name was, gee whiz, I forgot. You know what I'm talking about. But she wrote this song, and she went and sang it to him, and it was a good way for them to say goodbye, because she really meant this. And it's really like that when you say goodbye to somebody. You know, when you say goodbye to somebody you love, you wish them well. And this song is by Dolly Parton. It's so beautiful. It's called I Will Always Love You. This song was recorded in 1973. This was number one on the country charts in 1974. And then again in 1982, Porter Wagoner. Right, thank you, Loopy. She wrote this song for Porter Wagoner, who produced a TV show that she was on for many, many years, 7 years. And this song was a hit again in 1982 because it was in this movie called The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. Thank you. I love you. I love you. I sing that song because I love you, and I will always love you. Hey, thanks, everybody. This has been the best time ever. I've loved this. Cece, I know, has loved it, too. It's just us, you know? It's just me and you, and we're just working through some feelings tonight and stuff. And y'all who have experienced loss in your life and in this last year or before or after or whatever, because I know you will experience life. That's part of life. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for the hurt that you feel. It's close. It's dear. It's part of life. It's part of the experience. So I hope that you can appreciate it for the value that it has to you. And I hope that you receive the comfort and joy in your life to counterbalance that, you know? You know what I mean? That's all there is to it. And someday we're all going to die. So, you know, you can look forward to that. But more importantly, we can use it, you know, to remember, to appreciate. Because you don't know what's right around the corner, you know? You don't know what's right around the corner. You might fall in love. You might die. You might get a life-changing injury or accident. Somebody that you love very close to you could die or go away forever. I mean, you know, you never know what's going to happen. So you got to roll with the punches, people. Stay afloat, you know? Help each other out. I mean, I don't know what to say about it. It's all just the same old thing I always talk about. Who among us does not have heartbreak to heal? That's right. That's right. If you have a heart, you know it's soft, you know it's tender, and you know it hurts sometimes. So, thanks so much for joining me tonight. I'll be back next Saturday again with another Sandy Beach's Saturday Night Special. We'll work out some more feelings. I don't really know what the theme's going to be. It's probably going to come to me in the morning. I got one more song, actually. I got one more song. I can't believe how late this show's going, but I played this song for you once before. I played this, our ninth show, Young and Old, on May 16th, and I just thought this was a perfect little short little song, kind of encapsulate my blessing to you, oh very young one. If you're still alive, if you're on earth at all, then this goes to you. Oh, very young one, when you leave us this time, you're only dancing on this earth for a short while. And though your dreams may toss and turn you now, they will vanish away like your daddy's best jeans. Denim blue faded up to the sky. And though you want to last forever, you know he never will. You know he never will. And the patches make the goodbye harder still. Oh, very young one, when you leave us this time, there'll never be a better chance to change your mind. And if you want this world to see a better day, will you carry the words of a love with you? Will you ride the great white bird into heaven? And though you want to last forever, you know you never will. You know you never will. And the goodbye makes the journey harder. Dancing on this earth for a short while. I love you people so much. I love you people so much. Another great Saturday Night Special in the books. That was our 41st show, people. I love you so much. I'm sorry for your losses. I'm sorry for the pain you got to endure to be alive, but I know it's the price we pay. Enjoy yourselves. Treat yourselves. Treat each other. You're the best. I love you. Sandy Beaches, signing off. Bye.